Hello students, from today we'll begin with a new chapter, that is bacteria. As far as university examination is concerned, this chapter is most important. Most of the questions can be asked on this chapter, long answer or short answer question. So let us begin with chapter. So bacteria, as all of we know that the cells are divided into two categories, that is prokaryotic cells and eukaryotic cells. Now all of you will stop the video and you will find out the answer, what is the difference between prokaryotic cells and eukaryotic cells. Okay, now let us see what is the exact difference between prokaryotes and eukaryotes. In case of prokaryotic cells, the DNA, it is not enclosed within nuclear membrane. Means the DNA or nuclear membrane is not well developed, or it is not well established. A single cellular chromosome is present in prokaryotic cells. It is not associated with histone proteins. In case of prokaryotic cells, it lacks the membrane enclosed organelles like mitochondria, chloroplast or Golgi complex. These are absent in prokaryote. The cell wall usually contains peptidoglycan, a complex polysaccharides, and is divided by binary fissions. The ideal example of a prokaryotic cell is the bacteria. Okay, next is the eukaryotic cells. Okay, so what is eukaryotes? Eukaryotes, in this case, the DNA is enclosed within nuclear membrane. The several linear chromosomes are present. It is associated with histones and other proteins. Eukaryotic cells have membrane enclosed organelles like mitochondria, chloroplast, Golgi complex, endoplasmic reticulum, and these are divided by mitosis. Next, in this slide, you can see the exact difference between prokaryotes and eukaryotes. So here we can see, in case of prokaryotes, the cell size, it varies from 0.2 to 2 micron in diameter, whereas eukaryotes, they are quite bigger in the diameter or in the size, 10 micron to 100 micron. The nucleus, it is absent in prokaryotes, where it is present in eukaryotes. The membrane organelles are absent in prokaryotes, these are present in eukaryotes. The cell wall, as compared to eukaryotic cells, the prokaryotic cells are chemically more complex. But in case of eukaryotes, they are more simple and these are present. Ribosomes, smaller ribosomes are present in prokaryotes, but in case of eukaryotes, larger ribosomes are present. The DNA is single cellular or circular chromosomes are present in prokaryotes, but in case of eukaryotes, double helical structures are present. The cell division, it is by binary fission in prokaryote, whereas in case of eukaryote, it is the cells are divided by mitosis. The cytoskeleton is absent in prokaryotes, whereas it is present in eukaryotes. So let us have some background information or background of bacteria. What are the bacteria exactly? Okay. So microorganisms are too small to be seen without use of microscope. Already we discussed that microorganisms, they are very small objects. They are very small organisms, and we cannot see the microorganisms without any technique. So we require a special instrument or special technique in order to study these microorganisms, and that instrument is called as microscope. The techniques such as sterilization and use of culture mediums are required to isolate and grow the microbes. The culture medium, it is a medium required for the growth of bacteria. The bacteria may be spherical, or it might be rod shape, it might be spiral, or it might be filamentous. most bacteria can divide it into gram positive and gram negative group based on their cell wall. Okay, we'll study the gram staining technique in later part of the chapter, but for your understanding, the bacteria are broadly categorized into two classes based on their cell wall, that is gram positive and gram negative. The bacteria such as mycoplasma, the mycoplasms bacteria, they lack cell walls, means cell wall is absent in such case of in such bacteria. Now let us look at the size and shape of bacteria, the arrangement of bacteria. The bacterial size is ranges from 0.2 to 2 micron, means the bacterial diameter, it is ranges from 0.2 to 2 micron. But in case of human RBC, it is near about 7.5 to 10 micron in diameter. Length of bacteria, it is 2 to 8 micron, and some cyanobacteria are up to 60 millimeter long. Okay, now here we can see that the diameter of bacteria is 0.2 to 2 micron. That is, the smallest bacteria which is known has a size of 0.2 micron. So that's why when we fit the HEPA filter, and when we talk about HEPA filter, the diameter of HEPA filter is 0.2 micron or less than that. That means the smallest bacteria which is known can be filtered through that HEPA filter. That's why it should have size less than 0.2 micron. Okay. The bacterial cell have large surface to volume ratio. Therefore, all parts of the cells are close to the surface and can be quickly reached by the nutrients. So here we can see the differences between the bacterial cell, viruses and human cells. Here we can see the virus. Virus has size 225 nanometer. This is the adenovirus having size 90 nanometer. Okay, then this is the poliovirus having size 30 nanometers. This is the bacteria. Here you can see the E. coli. It is having size 3000 by 1000 nanometer, means near about 3 micron. The size of bacteria is 3 micron. Okay, the virus 30 nanometer, bacteria 3 micron, where here you can see the human RBC is having size near about 10 micrometer. This is the size difference between the virus, bacteria and human RBC. Okay, now let us take example of spherical shape bacteria. Cocci are spherical in shape. There are different, the cocci are divided into different classes based on the arrangement of bacteria. Diplococci means pair of cocci attached together, or when two cocci they attach together, they are called as diplococci. Streptococci means chain like arrangement, it's called as streptococci. Then tetrads, a group of four are divided into two planes, are called as tetrads. Then sarsens, a group of eight are divided into three planes, are called as sarsens. And staphylococci means grape-like or cluster-like arrangement of bacteria, are called as staphylococci. Okay, so as discussed in previous slides, when we talk about a single cell, single spherical cell, it is called as coccus. Single spherical cell called as coccus. When two cocci, they form a group, it is called as diplococci. This is one cell, this is second. So two cocci attached together are called as diplococci. When there is a chain-like arrangement, here you can see one, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. 8 cells, they form a chain-like arrangement. That's why they are called as streptococci. Here in this case, 4 coccus forms a group in a 2 planes. They are called as tetrads. Here we can see the 8 cells. It forms the group in 3 planes. They are called as sericids. Whereas in case of this last image, staphylococci, we can see the cluster-like arrangement. Okay, cluster-like arrangement are called as staphylococci. It is like a grapes-like arrangement. You might have seen the grapes. Okay, so these bacteria forms a cluster. They are called as staphylococci. So again, I am repeating. The diplococci means 2 coccus forms a group called as diplococci. Tetrads, 4 cells attached together in a 2 planes called as tetrads. Sericins are the 8 cells attached together in a 3 plane. And the staphylococci, a cluster-like arrangement, are called as staphylococci. When we talk about cocci, when we say cocci, the shape of bacteria is spherical. Another class of bacteria is bacillus. When we talk about a single cell, it is bacillus. And when there are number of cells attached together, then we call it as a bacilli. Bacilli are different from the cocci. Bacilli are rod shape, whereas cocci are spherical shape. Most of the bacilli appears as a single rod and might be seen as a diplobacilli or streptobacilli. Similarly, in case of bacillus, when 2 bacilli attach together, they are called as diplobacilli, and when there is a chain-like arrangement, then they are called as streptobacilli. There is again one more class of bacteria called as coccobacilli. It means it has oval rod shape, means they are neither rod shape nor spherical shape. They are oval rod shape, like this or this. Okay, so they are called as coccobacilli. So here we can see single bacillus rod shape. We can see here. This is the rod shape of bacteria. We can see here the shape of bacteria is rod shape. Single bacillus, rod shape. When 2 bacilli attach together, they are called as diplobacilli. This is the streptobacilli. Here you can see the chain-like arrangement of bacilli. Here, the 2 cells attach together, that's why they are called as diplobacilli. This is the single cell. Okay? And this is the coccobacilli, where they are neither rod shape, neither nor spherical shape. Okay? So, this is about the size and shape of bacteria. Apart from that, there are certain bacteria which has spiral shape. It have one or more twist. There is again one more example, Vibrio, a comma shaped bacteria. It looks like a curved rod. Then Spirilla or spirochetes. They are having helical shape or the cork screw shape bacteria with rigid bodies. But in case of spirochetes, they are helical bacteria with flexible bodies. So here is the example, Vibrio, they are comma shape. These are the spirillum and spirochetes. Okay, they are having spiral arrangements. Okay, spirillum and spirochetes, whereas Vibrio, it is comma shape. There are some more less common shape of bacteria. It is star shape, flat and square shape, and triangular shape bacteria. We'll see some of the examples. The micro cocci, they are gram negative cocci having size range of 0.5 to 2.5 micrometer in diameter, and they divide in more than one plane to form a regular or irregular cluster of cells. There are three important genera of micrococci, that is Micrococcus, Staphylococcus and Streptococcus. These are the examples of Micrococcus. They are aerobic, gram positive, catalyzed positive, cell arrangements mainly in pair or tetrads, are having irregular clusters. They are non-motile and they form yellow or orange or red in color. Their colonies are either yellow, orange or red in color. So aerobic means they require oxygen for their growth. They are gram positive. We'll study the difference between gram positive and gram negative, but just for your understanding, they are gram positive bacteria. Catalase positive means this bacteria has ability to produce or to secrete catalase enzyme. The cells arrange mainly in pair, that means diplococci, or tetrads means they can arrange in two planes in a group of four cells. They are non-motile, means most of the bacteria are motile and some bacteria are non-motile. How the bacteria moves, how they are classified based on their flagellar arrangement, that we'll study in next lecture. Okay, but just for your understanding, remember some bacteria are motile, some are non-motile. Next is Staphylococcus. They are facultative, anaerobic, gram positive, usually form irregular clusters. Staphylococcus, already discussed. Staphylococcus means cluster like or grape like arrangement. They are non motile, catalase positive but oxidase negative. They ferment glucose anaerobically. Next, Streptococcus, already discussed. The chain like arrangement are called as Streptococcus. Okay, so these are the examples of spore forming rod shaped bacteria. Almost all the spore forming bacteria are gram positive. Most means almost all the spore forming bacteria are gram positive. Okay, so these are the bacillus, aerobic bacillus means Bacillus subtilis, then Bacillus mycoides. All these are the examples of aerobic bacillus, gram positive bacteria, and these are anaerobic Clostridium, gram positive. Okay, so just remember the examples of gram positive bacteria, Bacillus subtilis, Clostridium species, all they are gram positive. Then the gram negative bacteria, non spore forming bacteria. Okay, the examples are Escherichia coli or E. coli, then Proteus, Pseudomonas, Acidobacter, Rhizobium. These are the gram-negative bacteria. Okay.